10 pounds, I think he's gonna make 923.
Alright, 30 pounds, I'm gonna break Griffin's heart. I'm gonna say 890.
30 pounds, I'm gonna think like he's gonna go higher, like 947. 948. Yeah, 948.
30 PSI, I'm gonna say 913. Low 900, but I'm pretty confident 913 on 30 pounds.
878 is my guess.
935. Time to ram some more time in her down low so she can get off the line in third better. I think if we can make like 800, 850 in third, she's in the boogie after the gate, and then give her everything in fourth. All right, so it's been kind of lazy on the torque. It's made like five, what was the torque, like 570?
Yeah, something like
560, it's pretty linear, so he's gonna try to ram more time in it down low, get the boost up and get it hitting harder in the mid range. So about to load the new tune now.
It made 889 on 34 pounds, so now he's adding more time in so we don't have to keep ramping the boost up yet. So he's gonna mess with that, and then we're gonna start adding more boost again.
I did not think it was gonna make that much. I thought it was gonna make like high 600s, low 700s.
To make almost 800.
Granted, that map is supposed to make like 17, 18 pounds, but with the duty he's got in it, it's making a little bit more. But so we hit like right just below 23 pounds. So let's see what it does on fucking 30 plus.
Made 868 on 33 pounds. I'm sending him the log now.
Did you say
33? Definitely low for 33.
Well, this is not the portion of the video I wanted to make, but safe to say it smells like my garage just got hotboxed with coolant, so we're gonna jump in and talk about all that shit in a second. Might as well sit in there while we talk about it. So, and a very, very, very unfortunate thing happened on the dyno day. So I'm gonna put all the clips of the rest of the dyno day after this part. I'm just gonna talk a little bit to make you guys understand what happened. But the pulls were going great. Keep in mind, tuned the car on the street to begin with, so we already got some data under our belts before we threw it on the dyno. We're thinking we're just gonna have to make a couple hits and be wrapped up. But dyno day started off great. I think the first hit the car made on like 23 pounds, 21 pounds, something like that. It made like 780. We're like, wow, first hit, that's fucking awesome. Ramped it up. I think it made like 830, 840. And ended up making like 850 on 24 pounds, which we're like, hell yeah, that's fucking perfect. We're right on track to make 1,000. We started having some issues throughout the day. The car started breaking up really bad, and we weren't sure what was happening. At first, we pulled all the plugs, ended up finding out one of the porcelain on one of the plugs cracked. Like, fuck. Have to run 2 hours away to go get plugs while we're still using dyno time, everything of that sort. And we get back, and once we get back, we're back to tuning. So the car was starting like whether it'd make like 29 pounds, 31 pounds, 33 pounds. It was not making over 898. Like the 898 was like the highest marker that we saw. So we ended up saying, you know what? It's good here. We'll leave it at that. The car sat for like 30 minutes. And the car had no signs of any issues whatsoever on the dyno. Didn't push any coolant. Wasn't smoking, didn't get hot, nothing of that sort. Car sits for 30 minutes, we turn it on. Second I turned it on, I smell coolant. The second after I smell coolant, my buddy Taylor, who's outside, he goes, bro, I don't want to freak you out, but there's white smoke coming out the exhaust. And I'm like, oh my God, no way. Like literally no way. Like I just built this thing for 2 years. I bought the best of everything to make sure it works perfect. And we popped the head gasket or lifted the head. Not sure yet. Not finger pointed at anybody, just an unfortunate event. What we think might be the case is that the manifolds are too small and it's causing back pressure. We have no idea yet until we get the motor pulled out. So, of course, I'm super bummed about it. It's frustrating as can be after waiting for this long and spending this much money, but it is what it is. And we're just going to try to get it fixed as quick as we can, basically. It's like I said, no finger pointing, no bad blood if anybody. We're just gonna have to figure out what the case is so we can get old girl back on the road, because it was loving it at like 850 and then it just started not wanting to make a lot more power. So it is what it is. We're gonna get the motor pulled, we're gonna see what we have to do. Hopefully we can figure it out fairly quickly, but other than that, guys, we'll figure out what's going on with that once we get everything dived into. Soho's gonna take a look at the motor and we'll see what we got to do, but got to keep pushing forward. I know everyone's been waiting for it as much as I have. Trust me, I'm more frustrated about it than anybody is, because I've been waiting for this long to finally start making content, and now we're back on pause again. So We're going to get knocked out as quick as we can. The rest of the Dino Day videos are going to be dropped right behind this, so you'll be able to see all the pulls, everything that happened in between. And just stay tuned, guys. I'm going to keep my head up through it, just try to knock her out, and get her back on the road. Guys, we're on the way to the dyno. I'm freaking out, and we'll see you there. All right, guys, time to get this dirty girl cleaned up. We had to throw the R888s on for the dyno so that the radios don't get killed on it. So we're going to get her cleaned up, go pump some E, and we'll be off to the dyno. Stretch, gang. Get back, gang. Giving her the last pump before we get there. Why am I an idiot?
You didn't give me a fucking Type C. You gave me a Lightning.
Yeah. Idiot.
I thought that's what that is. Yeah. Why would you not want Lightning? It's fast.
Damn. Chapo's following me to the dyno. Guess what, you want to get the race in that bad, huh?
Go time, baby. Gave me a heart attack. I thought he said 1197. Holy fuck, dude, I'm about shit.
Yeah.
Well, guys, it's cutting out, and we do not know why. So my gas gauge doesn't work. I don't think there's any way we could use the full tank of fuel, but we're gonna try to roll that out right now and get this sucker filled up. All right, guys, I don't want to talk about this, but we'll talk about it. It was breaking up really bad in the dyno. We could not figure out why. And now we figured out why. So we just had to run to the AutoZone that's 45 minutes away to get 6 new plugs. And we're going to hope that's why it was breaking up. Obviously, it looks like it's why, but we'll find out in a second. All right, guys, well, after all that fucking running around and hecticness, it will not make past 898. So literally right at the 900 horsepower marker, which I'm not mad about. Realistically, it's probably what I'd run it out on the street, but we're running into a limitation. It's only at 77% on injector duty. We think it's either the intercooler or the manifolds are too small. So we want to see over 1,000. We're gonna have to change one of the two things up, if not both. But 900 wheel, it's gonna be the fastest this car has ever been. We'll see what it does on the street after we get her pulled on off.